In continuation with this chapter, now let's study the last topic and one of the important topic of this chapter, that is mutual induction. In the previous video, we have studied about self-induction, that is the method of inducing EMF in a coil itself and by the coil itself. And here, mutual induction is also the method of inducing EMF, but by the coil which is placed near to it and the coil which is connected through a battery. So the EMF or the phenomena of inducing EMF in a coil which is connected through a galvanometer by a coil which is connected through a battery. When placed near to each other, thus it is the process of inducing EMF in one coil or a closed coil due to rate of change of current by a nearby coil. Let's understand it with the help of a diagram. Consider a solenoid having N turns. One end of the solenoid is connected with a rheostat and to the battery. Having N turns, and the other end is connected with a key. And near to this coil, another coil is placed, which is connected to a galvanometer only. When the key is on, the current will start flowing through first coil called primary coil, and this is a second coil known as secondary coil. Because of the current passes, there is a magnetic field produced around this coil, and because of the change in magnetic field, as the current is increasing by the help of rheostat, and because of that there is an increase in magnetic field, thus increase in magnetic flux. And as the coils are placed near to each other, so the magnetic field lines will pass through second coil also. Now there is a change in magnetic flux in first coil, and there is some change in magnetic flux in coil 2 also. Because of change in magnetic flux in coil 2, there is an EMF induced in coil 2, and galvanometer shows deflection. And when we will release the coil, when we will release the key, then also there is a decrease in current, and because of the decrease in current, the magnetic field lines will decrease. There is a change in magnetic flux, and because of that, again EMF is induced in it. So this process of inducing EMF because of the coil 1 in coil 2 is known as mutual induction. And this can also happen in coil 2 when this coil 2 is connected through a battery and this galvanometer is connected to coil 1. Then the EMF can be induced in coil 1 because of coil 2. So we can say that as we have studied that the flux linkage, that is number of turns and magnetic flux linkage in coil 2 is N phi 2, and it is directly proportional to current I 1. As here we can see that as current increases in coil 1, then the change in magnetic flux will also increase. So we can say that as I 1 increases, thus the magnetic flux in coil 2 will also increase. Or we can write that N2 phi 2 is equal to a proportionality constant M21, where M21 is known as mutual inductance of coil 2 with respect to coil 1. Proportionality constant known as mutual inductance of coil 2 with respect to coil 1, or it is also known as the coefficient of mutual induction. Similarly, if coil 2 is connected with a battery, then the current will start flowing in coil 2, and because of that, there is a change in magnetic flux in coil 1. So here we can write that similarly, N1 phi 1 is directly proportional to the current flowing in coil 2, and its proportionality constant is equal to M12 into I2, where M12 is a constant, proportionality constant equal to mutual inductance of coil 1 with respect to coil 2, or coefficient of mutual induction. Or by this we can also write that M12 is equal to N1 phi 1 by I2. Similarly, M21 can also written as N2 phi 2 by I1. We can also define magnetic induction in terms of unit current. That is, we have seen that M21 equal to magnetic flux in 2 upon current in coil 1. That is, magnetic induction in coil 2 with respect to 1 is equal to magnetic flux linked with coil 2 when current I1 is flowing through coil 1. So if I1 is equal to 1 ampere in coil 1, then mutual inductance of two coils is equal to magnetic flux linked with coil 2. So its definition of mutual inductance is, it is defined as magnetic flux linked with secondary coil, that is coil 2, due to flow of 1 ampere, that is unit current, through coil 1 or through primary coil. Similarly, we can define for M12, that is the magnetic induction in coil 1 due to coil 2 is equal to the magnetic flux linked with primary coil due to the flow of 1 ampere current through secondary coil. Now, as we have studied by Faraday's law, that the EMF induced is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux. According to Faraday's law, EMF induced is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux. And if we consider mutual inductance of coil 2 with respect to 1, then EMF induced in coil 2 is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux in coil 2. And as we know that magnetic inductance of coil 2 with respect to 1 is equal to magnetic flux linked with coil 2 upon current flowing in coil 1. Therefore, phi 2 can be written as M21 into I1, or EMF induced is equal to minus d by dt M21 into I1. Or we can write in magnitude form, M21 can be written as, here as M21 is constant, so take it out and we can write E2 is equivalent to minus M21 di1 by dt. By this formula, we can also define magnetic inductance, that is M21 is equal to E2 upon minus di1 by dt. So, if rate of decrease in current is equal to 1 ampere, then M21 is equal to E2. Or if we will take its magnitude, then the rate of change of current is equal to 1, then M21 equal to E2. Or if di1 by dt is equal to 1 ampere, then M21 equal to E2. By this, we can define mutual inductance of two coils can be defined as induced EMF produced in secondary coil when unit current, that is when rate of decrease of current or increase of current, in primary coil is unity. let's see SI unit of mutual inductance. As M is given by flux upon current and unit of flux is Weber, unit of current is ampere in SI system. And we know, we have studied it earlier also, that Weber upon ampere can be written as Henry, denoted by H. And this is the unit of self-inductance. That is, the unit of mutual inductance is same as that of self-inductance, and Weber can also be written as volt second. So another unit is volt second upon ampere. Now let's study the factors on which mutual inductance depends. M depends on number of turns, and it also depends on the shape of turns. And on its size, that is its geometry. It also depends on the type of medium which we are using as a core. These four we have studied in self-inductance also, and another one is distance between the two coils. And their orientation. That is the angle between these two coils. Whether they are placed perpendicular to each other, whether they are placed parallel or making some angle with each other. So magnetic inductance depends on this factor also. Now next is reciprocity theorem. Under this theorem we will prove that magnetic inductance in coil 2 with respect to coil 1 is equal to magnetic inductance in coil 1 with respect to coil 2. Therefore we are giving it a common name, that is M, for mutual inductance. So let's prove it. For this, consider two long solenoids which are coaxial solenoids, that is having same axis. One is bigger solenoid and the another is a smaller solenoid, but their axis is same and having different radius, thus different area of cross section. But here we are considering same length of both the solenoids. Both have different number of turns, total turns. Let it be one solenoid and this is second solenoid, having radius R1 and this is having radius R2, consists N2 turns and this consists N1 windings. And through this solenoid, I1 current is flowing and their number of turns can be denoted by dot and cross. That is, the number of lines are perpendicularly coming out and going into the plane. Here also, the lines can be denoted by dot and cross. So these number of windings are N2 and in this there is N1 windings. Current is I1. I1 current is flowing in solenoid 1 and I2 current is flowing through solenoid 2. Now let the common area of cross section between solenoid 1 and 2 is A, and let current I1 is flowing and I2 is 0. So when I1 current is flowing through solenoid 1, then there will be magnetic field lines produced around solenoid 1, and the value of magnetic field बी वन ड्यू टू सोलेनोइड, वन इज इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट एन वन आई वन, वेयर एन वन इज द नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पर यूनिट लेंथ. इट कैन बी रिटन एज म्यू नॉट एन वन अपॉन एल, वेयर एन वन इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स पर यूनिट लेंथ इन टू आई वन. एंड नाउ द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंक्ड विथ सोलेनोइड टू ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी वन इज इक्वल टू फाइव टू इंटू, दैट इज द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंकेज, एन टू इंटू बी वन ए. सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ बी वन इन द इक्वेशन, इट इज इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट एन वन अपॉन एल इंटू आई वन इंटू ए, और वी कैन राइट फाइव टू अपॉन आई वन equal to mu naught n1 n2 a upon l. Or we have studied that phi 2 upon i1 is mutual inductance of 2 with respect to 1. So we can write mutual inductance of solenoid 2 with respect to solenoid 1 is equal to mu naught n1 n2 upon l into a. Now let's find the value of mutual inductance of 1 due to 2 and see whether they are equal or not. So just write it, M21 is equal to mu naught N1 N2 A by L. Now let's consider that there is no current flowing through solenoid 1 and current flowing through solenoid 2, that is I2. Because of the flowing of current I2, there is a magnetic field produced in solenoid 2, which is equal to B2, and its value is mu naught N2 I2. N2 is the number of turns per unit length, and we can write it as N2 by L, total number of turns per unit length. And the magnetic flux linked with solenoid 1 due to magnetic field B2 is equal to phi 1 equal to N1 turns into B2A, where A is the common area of cross section. Now, because here we are considering that certain number of magnetic field lines which are common, because here we are finding mutual inductance, and that is one is affected by other, and here this is the common area we are considering. So substitute the value of B2, which is equal to mu naught N2 I2 by L into A, or we can write phi 1 by I2 equal to mu naught N1 N2 by L into A. Phi 1 upon I2 is mutual inductance of 1 with respect to solenoid 2. Now here we can see that mu naught N1 N2 A upon L, and this is also mu naught N1 N2 upon L into A. That is, right hand side are same. Therefore, we can say that their left hand side will also be equal. Thus, we have proved by long solenoid that M21 is equal to M12. It follows reciprocity theorem and it is equal to mutual inductance. Magnetic energy density or magnetostatic energy density is denoted by rho b, and it is defined as the magnetic energy per unit volume. Magnetic energy is stored पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ सोलेनोइड विच इज लॉन्ग सोलेनोइड. वी आर कंसिडरिंग लॉन्ग सोलेनोइड सो दैट वी कैन इग्नोर एज इफेक्ट एंड इफ एज इफेक्ट इज इग्नोर्ड देन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन्स विल बी यूनिफॉर्म थ्रू आउट द सोलेनोइड. एंड नाउ लेट वी इज द टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ सोलेनोइड. And it is equal to total area of cross section into length of a solenoid. Its magnetic energy is given as half Li square. And we can substitute here the value of self inductance and the current. That is, as B is equal to mu naught Ni. Therefore, I is equal to B upon mu naught N. Also, self-inductance L is equal to mu naught N square AL. So, substitute this value in magnetic potential energy. We get half mu naught N square AL into B square upon mu naught square into N square. So, we are remain with 1 upon 2 mu naught B square AL is the total magnetic energy, and magnetic energy density is magnetic energy per unit volume. Therefore, UB is equal to 1 upon 2 mu naught B square AL, and volume of a long solenoid is area into length. Therefore, magnetic energy density is equal to UB upon V. That is 1 upon 2 mu naught B square AL by AL. We get B square upon 2 mu naught is equal to magnetic energy density, and this is same as that of electrostatic potential energy density, which is stored in parallel plate capacitor, that is equal to in electrostatic potential energy density stored is rho E equal to half epsilon naught E square, where this is the permittivity of vacuum and this is the permeability of vacuum, and this is in numerator and this is in denominator. Now we can also find the SI unit of magnetic energy density. Its SI unit is as it is the energy per unit volume. Therefore, energy is in joule and volume is in meter cube. Or we can write joule is equal to newton meter. Therefore, we get newton upon meter square. And newton upon meter square is the unit of pressure, also known as Pascal. So directly we can write its dimension. Newton is m1 l1 t minus 2 and meter square is l2, that is m1 l minus 1 t minus 2 is the dimension of magnetic energy density.